Good evening, friends. Welcome to Homoeopathy and Health. Today, we will discuss about the overall idea of homeopathy. What is homeopathy? Homoeopathy was developed in the late 18th century. It is a system of medical therapeutics introduced by a German physician, Dr. Christian Frederick Samuel Hahnemann. The word homeopathy is a combination of two Greek words, homeo and pathos. Homeo means similar, pathos means suffering. It is founded on demerit law, similia similibus curandur, which means like cures like. Homoeopathy is a natural form of medicine used by over 200 million people worldwide to treat both acute and chronic conditions. According to WHO, homeopathy is the second largest system of medicine in the world. The holistic nature of homeopathy means each person is treated as unique individual and their body, mind, spirit and emotions are all considered in the management and prevention of the disease. History of Dr. Hahnemann is itself a vast topic, which we will discuss in detail at a later stage. For time being, here we will see it in a capsule form. Dr. Hahnemann was born on Meissen, Germany in 1755. He had his schooling in Meissen itself. Then in 1775, he went to Leipzig to study medicine. Then he went to Vienna for practice of medicine. There he worked with Dr. von Quarin. After that, he had worked as family physician and librarian to the governor of Transylvania. In 1779, he went to Erlangen and received Doctor of Medicine from Erlangen University. In 1780, he started practice at Hertstedt. In 1781, Dr. Hahnemann was appointed as MO of Health at Gommern. He was so enthusiastic to take up his job and applied himself very dedicated to the profession, but he could not obtain a healing response in many of his patients. And in some cases, the toxic effects of some of the medicines caused greater damage to the health of the patient. Due to dissatisfaction in 1785, Dr. Hahnemann stopped the practice of medicine and he made his living from writing and translation. In 1790, the milestone event had happened while translating William Cullen's A Treatise on the Materia Medica. While translating the Cullen's Materia Medica, Dr. Hahnemann had noted the claim the drug Singona was effective in treating malaria because of it was a bitter astringent and has tonic effect. This claim inspired Hahnemann to conduct experiment upon himself with the Singona for understanding the effects in a healthy person. Dr. Hahnemann took 4 drams of quality Singona twice daily for many days. After a few days, his feet and fingertips became cold. He became drowsy, pulse became hard and quick. He developed anxiety, trembling, prostration and pulsation of head. In short, all the symptoms associated with intermittent fever. Each paroxysm lasts for 2 to 3 hours and the symptoms recurred whenever he repeated this dose. After this experiment, Dr. Hahnemann came to the conclusion that the action of Singona bark in intermittent fever is not due to its tonic action on stomach or bitterness, but due to its ability to produce symptoms similar to those of intermittent fever in healthy person. Finally, in 1796, Dr. Hahnemann had introduced homeopathy to the world through the work Essay on a New Principle for Ascertaining the Curative Powers of Drugs. Definition of homeopathy. The term homeopathy signifies a system of treatment based on similarity between symptoms of patient, those obtained during the drug proving on healthy human being. Homeopathy simply means treating disease with remedies prescribed in minute doses which are capable of producing symptoms similar to the disease when taken by healthy people. Homeopathic preparations are termed remedies and are made using a process called homeopathic dilutions. Homeopathic medicines are safe to use as they rarely cause side effects. What does homeopathic treatment involve? Homeopathic doctors work in the same way as any of other conventional doctors. History taking, examination and investigation are all important in establishing the diagnosis. The homeopathic consultation. Questions about patient's lifestyle, eating habits and preferences, temperament, personality, sleep patterns and medical history help the doctor to form a complete picture of the patient. Homoeopathy is also taken in tablet or globules, but it is also available in liquid and powder form. The doctor may also prescribe homeopathic gel or cream for topical use as well. Homoeopathic use around the world. Worldwide, over 200 million people are using homeopathy on a regular basis. Homeopathy was introduced in India in the early 19th century. Mahendralal Sarkar was the first Indian who became a homeopathic physician. The Indian government has recognized homeopathy as a medicine and set up the Central Council of Homeopathy to regulate its education and practice under the Ministry of Ayush. India leads in terms of number of people using homeopathy, with 100 million people depending homeopathy for their medical care. There are over 2 lakh registered homeopathic doctors currently, with approximately 12,000 more being added every year. Homeopathy in Kerala. Christian missionaries brought homeopathy to Kerala 130 years ago. Its popularity increased by the effective management of epidemic cholera outbreak in South Travancore in 1920. In the year 1928, a resolution moved by Dr. M.N. Pillar in the Srimoolam Assembly paved the way for the recognition of homeopathy as a system of medicine in India. Homeopathy was also included in the Medical Practitioners Act of 1943 and included in the Travancore Cochin Medical Practitioners Act of 1953. Now, we will see the homeopathic facilities offered by the government of Kerala. We have hospitals, dispensaries, specialty clinics and projects. All the data which we are going to discuss are obtained from the official website of Department of Homeopathy, Government of Kerala. There are 34 hospitals with total bed strength of 985. Diagnostic and accessory management facilities. USS in 5 hospitals, 23 clinical labs and ECG facilities. We have 669 regular dispensaries, 416 NHM dispensaries, 29 temporary dispensaries in scheduled caste dominant areas in the state. 3 floating dispensaries and 4 mobile dispensaries are also available. Specialty clinics. Special OPs on specific disease conditions such as diabetics, thyroid, asthma, allergy, etc. are currently conducted in district hospitals on specific days by medical officers from the peripheral dispensaries. Specialty projects. REACH, Punarjani, Janani, Chedana, Ayushman Bhava, Sadgamaya, Sidalayam are the ongoing specialty projects by the government of Kerala, in which the epidemic control measures are being initiated under the REACH program by distributing preventive medicines, conducting medical camps, health awareness programs, etc. Under this program, we had distributed Arsal 30 as a preventive to COVID-19. Further, Government of Kerala also proposed certain specialty projects for transgenders and for liver disorders. These are the 5 homeopathic medical colleges in Kerala. Out of these, Government Homeopathic Medical College, Thiruvananthapuram and Kozhikode are also offering MD courses. Further, the National Homeopathy Research Institute in Mental Health in Kottayam also offers MD course. These are the list of subjects included in the BHMS course. We could see that a lot of subjects has to be learned in the course. Thanks for watching. Please support and share our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel for the upcoming videos.